49 out of 50 states are economically underwater. Plus, I'm going to talk about Arizona's new immigration law and the backlash. Hey guys, it's April 29th, 2010. My name is Reginald. I'm also known as Dimcad. First, 49 out of 50 states are showing less economic activity in February than they did a year ago. So essentially, when you look at the economic activity of last year, February, and you compare that to the economic activity of February of this year, virtually all the states are showing less activity. This chart right here pretty much tells you the entire story. Euro is also suffering. The euro hit a one-day, well, it was going towards a one-year low. And this is as a result of the downgrades. The S&P downgraded Spain recently, and before then, it downgraded Greece, and it downgraded Portugal, and I think there's going to be some more. I wonder, how can the U.S. have a AAA rating status, or how can the U.S. have a high credit rating status when all these other countries are going down? I mean, who really has faith that we can pay back all the money that we owe? Okay, Vatican. The Pope may apologize for abuse by priests. He may apologize. Oh, wow. Stop the presses, okay? if it was any other organization that did what this organization did, oh, man, the backlash would be intense. Anyway, Arizona. Monograph did a video about Arizona's new immigration law, and this law allows law enforcement officers to basically profile or demand IDs and documentation of people who they suspect of being illegal immigrants, which brings up a whole number of issues, you know. So how do you decide who gets carded and who doesn't get carded, you know? One, I think we need to have secure borders. I want us to have secure borders. I think it's just common sense. We need to have secure borders. I do want to see a crackdown on illegal immigration and all types of illegal behavior. And I always have wanted that. But I think that if they were really serious about targeting this problem and really dealing with this problem, they would focus on the causes of this. You know, on our side, we can focus on businesses that employ illegal immigrants. And that's one part of it. Instead of wasting time going after the illegal immigrants themselves, we can focus on their incentives for actually being in this country in the first place. And if we went after the businesses, that would be a more effective way of eliminating their incentive to come here in the first place. Another thing is trade. The trade laws. There's a reason why these immigrants keep coming into this country, because they don't have any realistic opportunities in their own country. I think that we should, as a country, create fair laws, fair trading laws that allow Mexico to build their own wealth, so that a lot of these people don't feel the need to come into our own country. So I think we need to focus on the root causes. I guess I just want consistency. You can't really have a situation where corporations exploit illegal immigrants for decades, have open borders, and then when the economy goes downhill, say, oh, we got to get them out of here, and try to make it seem like they're the problem, and try to target them. I mean, it just seems kind of shady to me. I mean, if we really wanted to end illegal immigration, we would know how to do it more effectively than this. And this all just seems like a cop-out to me. But I don't know. What do you guys?
This law,
I don't think it's really going to solve much of anything. And it's causing a great backlash. There's going to be a lot of Hispanics, a lot of Latinos, and liberals and Democrats who are going to be rallying in protest to this. So things should be quite interesting. Is this a open door for racial profiling? I mean, come on. I don't know. I want illegal immigration to be dealt with, but I think there's a more effective way to do this. Okay, high school graduates head to college in record numbers. Okay, some 70.1% of the 2.9 million new graduates between ages 16 and 24 are headed to colleges and universities. Sounds like good news, right? This is part of a trend, and it's been going up and up. In 2008, 68.6% of high school graduates headed to college. And this is compared to 1999, which was 62.9% that were headed to college. You know, it's good that more people are seeking education, but the problem is a lot of these colleges are offering a great deal of degrees that are essentially useless. So, I mean, what good is it to go into debt and end up with a degree that's useless? So, I hope they're getting good college degrees, degrees where they can actually get jobs. Okay, U.S. police seizing private property for profit. This is something I learned about when I was in school acquiring my degree in criminal justice. Police and prosecutors basically seize private property without ever convicting, without ever charging people with the crime. You don't even have to be charged with a crime, and they can seize property. It sounds unbelievable, but this is based on a study. Okay, they can keep or sell what they've taken or use the profits to fund their own budgets. There's a huge potential for corruption right there, or misuse of power right there. And most states pretty much do this. And the study concluded that a lot of these states do this to pump up their budgets and under state and federal civil asset forfeiture laws. Civil, not criminal. Law enforcement agencies can seize and keep property suspected of involvement in criminal activity. Okay, unlike criminal asset forfeiture, there's, if you own a house or whatever, you could still lose that. And even if you're not found guilty of a crime or even charged, you can permanently lose your money, your house, and your car. I mean, it sounds outrageous, but I want you guys to check this out. I want you to check this link out. From 2001 to 2002, currency forfeitures alone in just 9 states totaled more than $70 million. Now, this excludes cars and a number of other things, but that just gives you an idea of what's going on. The Department of Justice forfeiture fund topped $1 billion in assets taken from property owners. $1 billion. Dollars. Wow. Okay, I just want to make 2 shout outs to 2 blogs that I often look at, and no, I'm not being paid by them. The comingdepression.blogspot.com. I go there a lot. I go there every day, actually, among other places. SHTFplan.com is another blog that I go to. I mention these 2 because these are places that I get information from, so I figure if I'm getting information from them and I think they're doing a good job, it only makes sense to at least mention that. If you guys can think of any other good blogs, because I'm always looking for good blogs about the economy and politics, if you can find any other good blogs, please let me know, and I'll be mentioning them if I actually use them. So I would also like to thank Skyding for helping me out with the link, so thanks for that tip. Also, regarding the knife, I did purchase the K-Bar knife, so K-Bar Browning, so I'm going to check that out, test it out, I'll do a video on it. Thank you for your help, and thank you for watching this video, and have a good day. Alright. Oh, and don't forget, the future belongs to those who prepare for it today. Bye.